And welcome back to some more Enshrouded. Right, okay, so I'm going to attempt to showcase my healer build, since right now my daughter's sleeping. No idea how long she's going to be sleeping for. My cat is also sleeping, and my wife is at work, which means that I had a couple of options. I could either clean up the house, which I really should do, and I have a couple of videos that I could edit, but I wanted to play a little bit and see if this is actually going to be viable. Okay, so first off, we're just going to start off with, well, I guess the food buffs. We go with eggs, we go with a little bit of meat wrap because of the constitution and intelligence, and we go with glow soup because of more intelligence. And that leads us with 20 intelligence. Okay, I mean, sometimes that gets turned down. I'm not really sure how that works. Okay, let's get into talents. I'm just gonna go over this quickly. I mean, obviously, updraft, double drum, jump, and rebound for convenience sake. And then we have spec'd into lightning and frost, all the way into lightning. And for the healers, healer spec, yeah, we spec'd into basically the water aura. I mean, you don't really need the martyr because I don't plan on dying. Necromancer skill comes in quite handy. Blink and emergency blink, very important because you get stunned all the time. And we've spec'd into wands. Now, the reason we've spec'd into wands is because, well, you will run out of mana at some point, even though we have massive mana regeneration. But yeah, it's good to have something to do damage while you wait for your mana to regenerate. And of course a little bit into, well, constitution and protection, just for the health's sake. As for the armor, we go with a full sage set because every piece includes healing. Now this set you could obviously subsidize with something that gives more damage or protection, but I mean this is the set that I'm using with my wife for our playthrough where I'm her pocket healer basically. Let's see, as for the shield, I mean the ethereal plane, just something that I've always used, and mana regeneration rings. Now for the weapons, we go with undergrowth staff, mainly because, well, look at their mana regeneration, and of course mana leech. Two tempest wands because they don't last long, and a frozen core wand because, well, it 10% mana leech. Yes, now this is a lot of shock damage, so that's probably going to be fine, just fine. Now, as for buffs, I think that we can consume just an elixir, like 30% damage multiplier, and probably, yeah, magic damage, that's something that we should definitely use. Other than that, I'm not sure, I mean, maybe just a little bit more stamina, for good measure. As for protection, yeah, might as well take one of these. Okay. So I'm trying to be quick about this because I have no idea how long my daughter is going to be asleep for. And since I have now the sole responsibility, there's the penis, of my daughter. That's a sentence that I shouldn't really say, but yeah. I might need to, you know, run away from the camera. And I mean, I'm not sure why I'm telling you. This is just a recording. It's not live streaming, but I did start off as a live streamer, so I guess that's still fresh in my mind. But we're gonna go with the Kindlewaste Hollow Halls, because that is what I believe is currently the most difficult challenge. Maybe. But we're gonna see. Okay, so just straight off for the spells. Oh, right. Yeah, I forgot about the spells. Let's see. Bone. Now, hang on a minute. I'm trying to do the thing. But yeah, it's fairly good damage, as you can see, just a couple of hits, I mean, and I heal up basically instantly, and yeah, the skulls that I summon, they do a lot of damage, too, that they do. They didn't used to be enemies here, did they? Did it? Okay, yeah, well, back to the spells. Eternal heal stuff, I mean, you don't really need that when you're going solo. At least not chain heal, you just need a heal channel. For offensive spells, we have Eternal Ice Bolt, Bone Charm, level 2. I tried Lightning, but it doesn't really work too well, like in actuality. But yeah, the Eternal Ice Bolt, that is in fact something, because it creates an area which, when enemies go through them, they get slowed, as you can see by those things. I mean, I do take a lot of damage, but, I mean, it's not too bad. Whoop. Ow. Well, yeah. But they're slowed, they don't really know what to do, and we just continue to spam our wand while we teleport away, and then we just automatically heal up everything because of the water aura. Ugh, that is fantastic. That is fantastic indeed. Now, I should also loot maybe some of the mages, because they do drop the summons, which either have been buffed or, since I'm expecting to intelligence, they do a lot more damage. I mean, you don't really need to repair, since the staffs don't take durability damage. They might in the future, since they did with the bows. But yeah, wands, they do not last for a long time. That's why I have two Tempest Wands. Right. I have also tested a couple of other spells, but it seems like just that this is the way to go. Just be a little bit careful. Yep. Just all the damage. Then everything is dead, barely took anything, and my water aura just heals up everything, which is rather nice. And we just freeze a couple of bastards. Oh, hang on, that guy got through, or maybe because it's a lunging move. I guess we'll see. And we can just teleport backwards. So a large group of enemies is not an issue, you just need to have to backpedal a little bit. Come on in. Yeah, it is a lot of damage. Now, I've tested out, like, the bone wand and some other stuff, but it seems like what I'm currently wearing is the best. Maybe. Not gonna say for certain. Yeah, we're gonna speedrun this a little bit. Just gonna jump in here. Actually, we can also jump in here and just fire off a couple of these. I mean, ice damage does do, I mean, not too bad. Then we just switch off to the Tempest Wands, and then we take them out one at a time. Decent damage, sometimes with crit, which is nice. As for the Ice Wand, that is just basically to regain some more stamina. Doesn't do the best damage, but it is something. And we do also have shield, so we are able to block a little bit. And there we go. And as you can see, if I use a little bit of mana, my mana regeneration is through the roof. And since you're mostly going to use wands, I mean, it is just amazing. Takes a lot longer time than, like, my two-hander build that it does. But, I mean, for a support class, this is fairly good. And let's see, let's hit that bastard. Oh, yeah, need to be a little bit quick about it, but yeah. And also, when the enemies hit me, they get frozen. Okay, let's continue off towards the boss. Went to intelligence, it's not bad. I mean, you could spec a lot more into intelligence to do more damage. That you could. But I think what I've found here is a rather nice build. Stay somewhat safe-ish. Just careful. A little bit of jump action. Take care of the ranged enemies. Then when they... When they get too close, just use a little bit of eternal ice. Ow, that hurt. Yep. Come on in. Whoop. I mean, there's gonna be a lot of teleporting around. As you can see, I can tank a hit or two. And that was the barrier. Easy enough. And stuff is dying around me. I'm not sure why. But yeah. Massive stamina regeneration, mana regeneration, and everything is fine and dandy. We're just storming through. Oh, you little biscuit. Okay, well, now for the boss. I mean, we might as well also take the hidden chest that is over here. That couldn't hurt. Let's see, right over here. As we do, as is tradition. Come on then. I don't have all day. I'm almost trying to speedrun this. Because my daughter can wake up at any moment. We went for a tiny little bit of a walk. My cat is feeling neglected since I know... it's only me here, so I can't really take him outside, but we did take him outside yesterday. Okay, let's see. Oh, hang on. Yeah, I forgot something quite essential over here, which is these things. Oh, okay. Slow them down a bit. Slow them down a little bit again. Now, I think there's something that has happened to the boss. Yeah, it happened last time too. Okay, so if we regenerate mana at quite a big speed, but yeah, he's stuck in the middle there, as you can see. Was that last time I tried this too? Ah, yeah. Still not too used to the infinite blight, and oh, so close. Okay, let's try this away, and like a soul. There we go. Yeah, he's just stuck over there. Okay, so if we now change to the bone channel, am I hitting him here? I am. Okay, so now I can just spam out all the damage. I mean, look at my mana, it's just basically infinitely regenerating. Like, look at my mana. Just like infinite mana. No worries whatsoever, and I'm just slaying the boss. I don't have to do anything, and... come on, a little bit. Oh, okay. Don't die, at least. There we go. That should be the boss. Now it's just for all the other fuckers around here. But we're just gonna loot the boss real quick. Okay, nothing too fancy. And, oh, ow, yeah, oh, so much damage. Yeah, the bone channel spell is incredible. Actually, while we're here, might as well test out a little bit of this action. I mean, this doesn't do any damage comparatively. Like, you have to be really close and, yeah, not really something I would recommend. Whoop. Okay, but now they're at least slow, so I can basically just run backwards. I still haven't used a single healing spell or a single pot. So yeah, this is something. Then again, the boss was stuck, so there's something weird going on there. But it is definitely a build. You what, mate? Okay, well, try not to die. Be bad. Okay, well, we are still gonna loot. Because we don't really do the entire dungeon. Let's see, edge. Hog chest, sure. Okay, out of my way. Now, again, if you just remove all of the protection, constitution, and maybe not even wand, then you can definitely make this into a very powerful mage build. But yeah, one thing that you should also have is probably the fireball to take care of the spawners. Eternal fireball, or any fireball spell would probably do. But I prefer the, eternal spells. Now, or, ow. Yeah, okay, to try not to die, that would be bad. But yes, I mean, it's, a lot of damage. A lot of damage. Oh, hang on, there's a couple of those bastards. Yeah, they could one-shot me. You just need to kite them around a little bit. Then everything is fine and dandy. The more stuff you kill, the more of the summons will summon. I mean, it's a little bit random, but that is fine. And just look at my mana. I am not spending any mana. It's just instantly regenerating. So I can just stand up here and fire off all day, every day. Ah, not bad. And they're just standing here and taking it. Then we can switch off to electricity for some more damage. And we can just walk backwards because they're frozen and they're dead. Yes. Ah, not bad. Not bad at all. Come on then. Here. There we go. And you could also just lump in a couple of these. Actually, how many can I use, I wonder? Whoop. Those. And for mana regeneration, we can just use the wand. And then it will just... I mean, yeah, everything is dead. I got an army of summons around me. Okay, take care of that filler while I look in here. Ooh, look at that. Yeah, I've tested this staff out as well, so that is... I mean, it's not best that it is not. Because I do prefer having, you know, infinite mana again. yes. But for destroying those summons, that is not really ideal. I wonder, like, regular ice vault, that doesn't help, does it? No. Yoosh. But yeah, not too shabby. Now, this is probably a good way to... This is probably a great way to get experience, passively, maybe. I should test this out, because you can make the summons, and if you just stand here, I presume you get experience. I don't think I can actually check, can I? No, because I have the maximum experience and it doesn't tell me. Let's see, I mean, I'm just gonna go over this thing for people who are interested. Let's see, status details, probably? Yeah, who knows? This is probably a great way to level up. Maybe even when the level cap eventually gets increased. I mean, there was a little short from Keen Games that they're doing an update soon with skill? No, difficulty settings. That's gonna be interesting. Ooh, maybe a creative mode. That would definitely be something. Not something that I'm gonna use on this character, because I do like to have, you know, proper is not the right word, but, you know, a realistic world, per se. I mean, you can technically already go into creative mode right now. You just, well, you don't even have to download a world. You could just jump into a resource server, get everything you want, and then, you know, get into your main world. But yes, so not a bad build at all. Now again, there's multiple ways. Hang on. Oh yeah, I've sorted my weapons. Let's see, where's the staffs? They're over here. One thing that I also want to bitch about is, not the Mirage, the Shroud Weaver. They nerfed my Shroud Weaver. It was level 35 before. Oh, the bastards. Ugh. Thought it was going to be a legacy weapon, but they took that away from us. But there you have it. A very nice healer build. Like, you do a lot of damage, and you do also... you can take quite a few hits as well. So that is not too shabby. Not too shabby at all. And you still have all of the maneuverability. I mean, you don't need all of this. You don't need updraft. I mean, you could make this into a proper mage build. But again, I think that this build is fun. This is the build that I'm using with my wife so that I can assist her and I can move fast and jump and like my stamina regeneration just pops off. I mean, it's not as fast as my other build, but that comes down to the armor. And let's see, if we do the Eternal Heal channel, yeah, if we just remove a lot of the mana, you can also just see what my mana regeneration is without anything, basically. It just fills up all the way. And you could get better armor for mana regeneration that you could, but it's something. Right, well, I think that should do it for a build guide-ish. I need to do something productive. So, as always, until next time.